Yes, commodities. As last week I have discussed gold, crude oil, which are traded in market, and today I will make you familiar with various aspects of copper. Sorry. Copper is one of the most versatile and widely used metals in the world and a widely traded asset in the major commodities market. In today's session, we will see what copper is and its history, as well as what affects copper prices and trading tips. Copper has so many industrial uses. It's an efficient conductor of energy, namely heat and electricity. It would be difficult to imagine building any significant industrial infrastructure without it. As developing regions like the African continent, Eastern Europe and Asia modernize their economies and expand their infrastructure, copper demand should grow. So, next, what is copper? Copper is an abundant reddish brown metal that is mined for its use across a wide range of sectors from agriculture to construction. Unlike other metals traded in the commodities markets, such as gold and silver, it is not considered as a monetary standard and so costs a lot less. However, some of the supply and demand forces that affect copper are the same, influencing its status as a volatile, widely traded asset in the major commodities market. Next, copper is used for a variety of applications from fertilizer to jewelry and household appliances. A strong and ductile conductor of heat and electricity. It is an important component in electrical equipment such as the wiring and motors. And it is also used construction for pipes and tubing. And it is also used in alloys such as brass and bronze, where it has a further application such as the jibs, wheels and ornaments. Next, history of copper. The history of copper goes back some 10,000 years when, during the Bronze Age, it was the first metal ever smelted. At that point in the history, when the commercial trading system was based on bartering, copper's value was measured against that of food, wine, livestock, and any other alternative materials. Copper has been used alongside gold and silver to make coins since the Roman era. But copper's low inherent value mean it was never considered a monetary standard. Fast forward to the 20th century and copper is being used all over the world in a wide range of sectors. As a result, the copper price has become increasingly linked to its industrial applications in the sectors mentioned above. The 2000s commodities boom saw copper surge dramatically in price, moving from around 1 USD per LB at the start of 2004 to 4 USD by LB by May of 2006. Next, now have a look at a chart. It shows prices from the 2012 to till today, as it describes various events. Supply, output, demand, and nearing all-time high of 4.6 at all. Next, the largest producer of the copper. Copper producers with the largest volume by country include Chile, Peru, and China. Indeed, Chile is responsible for more than double the output of the next biggest producer, that is Peru, with the former producing 5.8 million metric tons in 2018 compared to Peru's 2.4 million. The top 10 producers, along with their 2018 output in metric tons, are as follow: Chile, 5.8 million, Peru, that is 2.4 million, China, 1.6 million, US, 1.2 million, DR Congo, 1.2 million, Australia, 0.95 million, Zambia, 0.87 million, Indonesia, 0.78 million, Mexico, 0.76 million, Russia, 0.71 million. By company, as of 2019, the largest players in the copper market are Chile's Codelco and US-based Freeport-McMoRan and Anglo-Australian mining giant BHP Billiton. Next, what affects the copper prices? Supply, demand, and alternative metals. The price of copper is influenced by a range of factors based on supply and demand considerations as well as the outlook for alternative metals. Let us discuss in detail. Supply. Prices can be impacted by geopolitical and natural events that slow down the mining output, such as worker strikes and earthquakes. Next, demand. The demand side is fueled by net importing countries, which import more copper or other goods and services than they export. Over the past 100 years, the demand for copper has risen by almost 20 times as developing nations use it to expand their infrastructures and boost their economies. Additionally, the price of copper is linked to domestic housing markets, as the home building industry use vast amount of metals. So basically, this means that factors with an impact on the housing market often affect copper prices. such as example, non-farm payrolls, mortgage rates and GDP. Next, alternative metals. Lastly, the substitution of alternative metals can also impact the copper prices. If the price of copper rises too much, buyers will seek cheaper alternatives and demand will go down. For example, in the mid of 2000s, the rising price of copper led to advancement in the use of aluminium for wiring and automobile production. Next, how to trade copper? Copper can be traded in a range of ways, from copper futures and options in the commodities market to exchange traded funds. Where permitted, spread betting and CFD trading can also be used to speculate on whether copper will go up or down in price. Reasons to trade copper. Reasons to trade for copper are slightly different to those of gold and silver. While copper is popular among traders and has a variety of uses, it is abundant in supply. So, while gold and silver have inherent value, copper's price is tied to its utility. Copper price can be viewed as a measure of economic health, which is why copper has earned the reputation of having a metaphorical PhD in economics and the nickname that Dr. Copper. Therefore, traders have the opportunity to take a position on copper based on their view of world growth and GDP. But while speculating on the price of copper, it comes with a risk as well as. If the economy goes into the slowdown, the market would suffer. Commodity traders also need to consider that, like all metals, copper supplies are finite. So, it is believed the world reserve could be depleted in the next 60 to 70 years. So, friends, that's all for today. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.